I might crack out the other Xbox controller I have. This is getting ridiculous. Not tonight. It'll be for tomorrow's stream. Yes, there'll probably be a stream tomorrow, but it'll probably be at the regularly scheduled time. I think the controller is actively against me at this point. I can assure you, after doing the course this many times, I wouldn't mess up certain elements of the line. Like, I mean, obviously I fucked that bit up, but there are certain moments where the joypad just seems to spaz out. So I'm at the mercy of that too. So when you press and hold X, what it sometimes does, so X is the PlayStation equivalent of the brake button. When you press that and you're going really slow, sometimes she does like a kickstart. Obviously that's not going to be optimal, so I guess you do, like, the only reliable thing is to press down on the D-pad. You can't rely on the square button. That's a fun little mechanic. It's past midnight. How am I meant to get that? So sweaty. guessed it, yep. The caves are quite nasty as well. Does a kickstart from like nothing again, like I'm using like the square button because I'm just more used to it rather than use down. Cool. Boy piss balloon. Almost time to ban Stream Elements Bot for doing the fucking spam. let me just limber up. Some stretching. Some breathing. I'm now ready to have another attempt at it. Partner. Cool. Getting the law on that can be very tricky sometimes. Nice jump, but like I'm pressing right, tapping right, tapping right, tapping right, tap, tap, tap. But she's not moving, right? She's like going, like she's slowing down because the D-pad's just not properly calibrated. Let me see if there's some calibration I can do in RetroArch now. Probably not. Put it in the screen. I don't want to show anything. Controls. Port 1 controls. Is there a way to calibrate? Nope. I assure you, like, usually, like, this pad has been good to me for over 10 years, I would say. But, you know, there comes a time in every pad's life where it's just the wear and tear. And you might think, oh, he's blaming the pad. Oh, that old excuse. But, you know, it is what it is. It is what it is. Like, I am like, screaming at it just now. Not going right, and you could see how it, like, even I was like trying to get, but you could see I was doing I was doing that constantly. I mean, what do? I pause scum? Like, I don't know how to get around this controller issue without fishing out my spare, which I don't quite want to do yet. Points. Cool. 25 points though. The people that want to kill themselves over the badge. Placement of that particular icicle is not fair. Neither is that one. Salty to a lot of people, but I am. That's just how I deal with hardcore challenges, I guess, like this. Like, do not be afraid if you wish to talk to me. I'm not gonna bite your head off. I'm guessing most people that are watching are kind of lurking in general, you know? I can't expect that. See how fucking little C started? Like, how does she force a kickstart like that when I'm clearly pressing the square button, which is meant to be the brake button? What? I guess, like, during that entire motion of, like, pressing X, if I have slowed down enough, if I at all tap forward on the D-pad ever so slightly, you'll be wanting to kick off, so maybe that's it. Anyway... first one. This. I like it, but need to get that better jump off there. Slowing down becomes almost comically hard to try to perform. Like, it's just, it will not let you do it. If that makes sense. And this bit here is like, it's difficult when they're doing that shit. And it's basically expecting you to do that perfect too. So, those are the first two portions of the run that kill it. You got the balloons. You got another balloon thing. Right, get down to about here and we put the brakes on. Line it up. Brakes. Brakes. Why are you not turning the hutch? No. The one balloon could be the difference between an 89 and a 90. Like, these are the gimme balloons. You can't miss anything, it's basically saying. I feel like I've attempted this too late at night. I should have gone for this first and the sub game second. Because I now lack the hand-to-eye coordination. That's what I feel. That whole time when I was like flicking out, flicking out. Like, look, I'm just gonna quickly check to see if the controller is in the box behind. I think it is. It's like playing with an extreme handicap. Like, doing this with a fuck D-pad equals, like, got a better, like, chance of getting a slobby from a supermodel. Like this. You definitely can't turn around. Like, so what was this person talking about? You can turn around to get balloons? I'm certain that this is going way faster than that dude's version on YouTube. Like, way faster. I don't think I'm making that up. Like, we'll have a look at my one. I'll try and go as far as possible. And just compare the speed. Maybe the terrain is like it won't let me take a hard right. So it's basically I keep trying to turn right, it won't let me, and then I bump into the wall. So maybe I've got to keep it to the extreme left. Things that make you go, Yeah, things that make you go, Yeah. By the way, Humble Bundle has a Resident Evil pack for $43 or above. That's Australian, it's probably less for USD. You can get a whole lot of Resident Evil games. So you should look for you should look for the Humble Bundle for that. All right, so you've seen how fast that is, and then we go back here. Look, that's slower. That's slower. I'm sorry, that's like way slower as well. I noticed that vitesse and temps and milieu, those are French words, right? So it's almost certain that that guy is French, and therefore he's playing on a PAL system. And also, when you see them pass here, it's different. The PAL version is not as fast as the NTSC version, so it's an even harder challenge to get this done. That's all I'm saying. Oh, Dabkind, long time no see. Let me pause for Dabkind. Cheers to you. Ahua, which is Hawaiian for cheers. And what have you been playing? I'm pretty sure you stream. Why is Tifa using a snowboard in Finnec Fantasy? Super Animal Royale. I've never heard of that game. So in Final Fantasy VII, when you go to the Gold Saucer, you can play the snowboarding game. Usually it's Cloud. But sometimes it can be Cid. But if Tifa is in your party, she will insist sometimes on having a go at the game. And then you can allow her or not. But yes, this is a mini game that I must complete for an achievement. Because that's what my life is at the moment. Like, I'll quickly show you the screen.